Right, so here we're going for Singapore. Highlights of Ericsson Learn Racing. Going for quality, seems to be the only one me and Pedri are going for Hypers, since everyone else is going for Ultras just to, you know, make the first team really last long. I just figured that the Ultras just last as long as Hypers, so might as well take the hit and get a good place in quality. Yeah, I'm provisional pole so far at least. Just keeping it tidy. These Hypers are really good for quality, but then they're just gonna fall off after a couple laps. Nice Jordan in P3 so far. He's one of the first guys to finish the Ultra laps, so it could still change. Really close to the ball there, missing the apex there, which hasn't done us any favors. I'm actually down on our lap, but I think the last sector is the place where I'm gonna gain the most back of my previous best. Oh no, that's not a good line at all. Just through the tunnel in the last couple corners, finished that off. Probably the best section to drive these four corners. Then one around this corner, this last corner, just across the line. And it's even more of a pole lap. And yeah, that's pole. I'm going for the race. Starting from front row, out of infamous place, and then Pelosius and Hypers as well. Need to get a good launch on the better tyres, and as we have. We're away, keeping the lead. I think it's three wide behind us. Somehow survived, of course. No bad luck for them. Yeah, we just keep the lead. Trying to pull away as much as I can before these tires just fall off an absolute cliff. I think Jordan got involved in a bit of a crash in turn one, which, again, just bad luck for us. Good luck for Mercedes. What can you do with that? Yeah, coming at then to the end of lap 3 now. Tires are dropping off now and decided to pit. It's a bit too early, but have to, otherwise I'm just gonna drop off massively. So in the pits, I think Pelzer is gonna follow us as well. Which should be interesting. See where we rejoin. There's Pelzer, trying to get out ahead of him, but no, we're gonna have to wait. That's gonna cost a couple seconds. And yeah, that's us, the back of the field, at least no one else pretty much pitted. Apart from some guys who crashed in town.
Stop left in this strategy.
So there we go, P11, out of Pelzer still. Now we come back to the back of X-Power, who's had a bit of a mare crash or something. He hasn't got a front wing, so he's going really, really damn slow. Thinking he's gonna go for the left side here, since he's gonna pit, but no, he's gonna just drive it on the racing line, so I lost out. Now, Pelzer is on the back of me, which isn't gonna be nice again. Covering the inside, turn one, it's gonna set us up badly for the next couple corners. The DRS bit after those. And there goes Pelzer, he's closing in on DRS. Cover the inside, but he still goes for the inside. Misses the braking completely, and I'll just go for the switchback. And that was Pelzer down there. It was a pretty quiet race, other than those couple of things, and now there's a safety car. So there was a glitchy wall at the end of the second sector, which kept blowing people up. Now there's a safety car. I should be net P2, but we're about to see some people from the pits emerge and effectively take a free pit stop here. That's Dralex. It's almost taking the lead here. but he's gonna drop into P2 and Strelix who's down the field there. Now at the end of the safety car, just gearing up for a restart, trying to not have cold tires, which we almost managed to do. There goes Claes from the lead. Just keeping the car on the island. The cold rear is very easy to just bottle it here. Also sort of keeping caution to draw like slag, which can draw up some spirited works. And yeah, that was that race. Pretty quick stuff. Stuck in P3 and that was pretty alright. Rosberg was a bit further down in 4th. But he lost out to a penalty. Yeah, that's another podium, which is pretty special always. Not a win though. Only win's been like China. That's long away. Australex takes his second win, I think. Yeah, here we yes, the race dancing a bit. As Rosberg's dropped to P5 out of that. He was in a massive battle with, I think it was, Franglish and Sam, but then Franglish got caught up in a crash, like a glitchy wall, so he DNF'd and Rosberg's got lucky there and got P5, so championship's a bit closer, but now we're going for Russia in the same highlights, because two quick highlights, just smash them together. This quality hasn't gone well so far. Our first outlap pulled that, now we're going for the second lap, which as you can see has been the best lap, which is not promising for the last lap. Keeping it tidy up, bit of oversteer there, turned in a bit too early and the rear kicked out. Yeah, in practice this track was really nice to drive in quali. You could get into like a 29.8 compulsory. So aiming to get that, it's cautious here. As there's Franklin on his outlap, wasn't noticed us on our lap, so had to not take the racing line there to destroy my wing on him, so it's cost us a bit, but oh well. Coming to the end of the lap now. Pretty tidy stuff. Nothing too spectacular. Yeah, I managed to bottle the last lap, so this is gonna be, it's gonna have to be the one good lap out of 3. Two corners to go as Rosberg's gone quickest. Could have extended that a bit more, but oh well. It's P4, which turns into a lot less nice looking P8. Behind Jordan even. So that's the quality battle swinging to his direction as Rosberg and Dralex championship rivals on top as well. So that's nice. Going for the start. Pretty decent launch. Pretty on par with Jordan. I just needed to get out of Jordan and then just go after Bailey here. Braking pretty early but still nearly hitting LGS, which was a bit scary. Still going side by side with Jordan, he's determined to not throw this place away. Turn up the inside and got Jordan there. Around the outside, can he make it work? And LGS was smashed into Verstappen. So I think Jordan's playing a good wingman role here. Oh, that's very good. Not track is clear. As LGS is lagging horrendously. Not sure where he even is on anyone's screen, so that's fun to race against. Going for a DRS move on LGS. Up the inside. Pretty alright, even though it's lagging. Let's put us up one place. Now we're coming up to this massive train here. Just massive chaos going on, both Hasses and the Bobber tools being all over the place. And that's a nice bit of lag from Dralek's car, I think. Just stopped in the middle of the road. On the next lap I'm coming in for the pits, this race is kicking out already. So I decided to pit this lap, might be one lap too early, but I had to go for it, being stuck in traffic. No pit entry glitches for me, luckily.
We think you're going to start losing some tyre grip around now.
It should get out like close to, or like maybe even ahead of Trelex. We get a good pit stop. No, we've been held up for nothing, a couple seconds. Usual stuff. We're out even behind the LGS again, so we have to again tread the lag and try and overtake him. As Sam's behind us, but he's effectively not in the race. He couldn't take hold of his car and his connection was pretty bad. So he's jittering the LGS again. Trying to make a move on him. Have to go around the outside. Yeah, that's that done. Good, he didn't throw it up the inside again. On the next braking. Now in the back of Trelex and Verstappen and Bobberts, who are still smashing above. So Bobberts, I think he's struggling massively with his tires and he's just not giving up any places. Just desperately trying to hold on to places. We're just trying to have a look at this. Bobberts lagging, so we had to do an emergency dive bomb. Not destroy my wing because I'm not sure where his car is. Now Pelzer is getting from this. I can't take Bobberts because he's really lacking. Don't dare to brake late. Still broken normal place and still hit him. As Pelzer is gone through. Now in the back of Bobberts again and Pelzer, and Bobberts lost it. He's got wing damage and Pelzer is going really slow for some reason. So we got the inside. That's us up a couple places in space of like one corner. Now looking forward. Now Pelzer is coming back again. That's him gone. So I just decided to stick behind him and let him to like pull me along towards this group. And there's a big battle going on ahead. It's Pelzer, it's Trelex who spins, goes across the track. I lose my wing. And Trelex lost his wheel on that. It's effectively two championship contenders screwed. While Rosberg drives in there, pretty much in the lead. For second place, his Frankness is leading.
Alright, so
thank God for that.
Damage, and we think you should
not
be
have
okay
to with Pelzer.
It'll cost us a little bit of time.
With four laps to go, so it's gonna be a bit of a hit. His turn has gone by. It's hypers at the end, just pretty much just blasting it out, not worrying about the tire temperatures anymore. Not really worrying about anything, just too annoyed at this point.
Go now.
Yeah, we actually jumped Pelzer, who's had a bit of a merit in the pit stop for some reason. Behind Bobberts again, who's behind him. I need to overtake him again.
Okay, we've lost the position. That's
somehow finding the laggiest two guys to fight in this race. The worst track in the calendar. Yeah, we already caught up to him pretty much. Should look at a move on the DRS. Still some points on the cards, at least on this stretchable half of the race. If we can manage to get Bobberts, then that's a couple more points, even though Rosberg still P2 in the race, I think. Or thereabouts. Current answer to Bobberts, but he it's charging up the inside, just stubbornly trying to fight. Yeah, got around the outside, but still has the inside. And I almost lost my wing on him. Yet again. We survive. Good time.
There's 3 laps of fuel remaining.
Now the DRS is really closing up on him. 2 laps to go.
Okay, gap to leader, 41.2 seconds. Our gap behind is 5.0 seconds.
Just going for it, not even alongside, but still diving down the inside. That's hopefully him done. But no, he's still trying to go for it. As he throws up the inside here, proper Kimi Räikkönen and stuff from 2015, I just couldn't care less anymore.
Okay, gap ahead.
Now that's John,
9 seconds
ahead.
Seconds.
2 laps to go. Let's see how that turns out. Going for the drill here. Fastest lap. Something not much seen by me. I haven't pitted for the fastest tires at the end. Rarely have done that. No, it's just 1 lap to go and John's there. Within the view.
The car behind has a time penalty. Don't fight him for track position. We don't want an off.
I was really looking forward to the end of the race with no penalties on my part, just to pick up those easy places there with Bailey having a couple penalties and maybe even Rosberg having a couple penalties, but I don't think he did. Could be P4, P3 even. It's like all the dream go down. But we're still P6, so it's manageable. As we're sort of closing up to John. Checking for his penalties, and he actually has 6 seconds. At the end here. But I still decided to close up to go for it.
The time last lap was
really, I think he's lost his task completely.
They have a time penalty of 6.0.
He's really slow through here, and nearly ran into the back of him there. Lost my rear. Yeah, lost 2 corners to go. Could think about diving it, but no, sticking behind. Then I decided to go for it here. Just 1 moment through the final corner. Got P5 on the road. Would have got it anyway, but still, with pride at this. And yes, that's Franklin's winning, so great job from him, and then Rosberg and Bailey following him.